I first started writing songs, I used to write a lot more based on me growing up there. Just because that was what I knew, that was what I was around a lot. But when I started, after my first album, when I started touring so much, I think my writing really started moving more towards writing about sort of something a bit more itinerant, something a bit more related to my travels. I write a lot about traveling and being on the road and that sort of thing, because that's kind of my new hometown is tour, basically. So I started out writing a lot about sort of small town Oklahoma life. I think it shifted a bit more to traveling, though, is kind of the main sort of environment of most of my writing now.
Right to wrong, maybe strangers in our very own home.
The new album is very geared towards character studies on my friends, my family, the people around me. I'm not so much a literal writer. I like to take a bunch of people that are around me and kind of take characteristics from them and put them into characters, kind of grab a little bit from a lot of people and put them into a character. So they do still get written about, but just little bits of them kind of shoved into a different sort of a different character.
In a boyfriend's cool wagon on the 40 interstate.
From sitting around with my girlfriends and everybody kind of always having an opinion on if you have like a relationship that's kind of gone to the pits or something like that. Everybody always having an opinion, well, if he would have done this or if she would have done this, things would have been different. And it goes back to that small town thing where when you're going through a breakup, which is like a really private thing, in a small town, it's a very public thing. Everybody is in on it, and everybody has an opinion on it, and everybody's talking about it. So it comes from that, trying to make it this personal thing that you're dealing with in the midst of that. Yeah, I'm going up through the Midwest, and then up to the East Coast, and down the East Coast a bit, and then flying out from there over to England for a tour over there. Yeah, so I have been playing in Ireland a lot. It's just, there's a really cool music community over there and they like folk music a lot. And the last time I was over there, one of the presenters for the music show that I was on started asking me if I knew about the connection between Choctaws and the Irish people. And I had never heard this story before, which is really strange because I feel like I would have heard it by now. But he told me that back in the potato famine, the Irish potato famine, that the Choctaw Nation donated money to the Irish farmers who were going through a really hard time, the famine, the poverty, that sort of thing. Which, and the Irish people found that to be really touching and really important because they knew that the Choctaws themselves had just been relocated through the Trail of Tears. And so for them to give money when they really didn't have much at all either, was just really important for them. And so then a really famous Irish folk singer wrote a song about it. And so it's kind of like a story they tell in Irish folklore over there about the connection between and how much they like the Choctaw people. So it's kind of nice. We started playing live a lot of these songs. I talked to Mike a lot about kind of going away from a traditional sort of rock drums, which has a lot of cymbals, has a lot of sort of mid and high end, very piercing. But I've just been really inspired by a lot of the more indigenous music that I've been hearing. I've been doing a lot of stuff up in Canada with the Aboriginal People's Music Choice Awards. And so I've been getting to see so much really cool indigenous music lately. And so we kind of tried to like incorporate that a little bit, do something a little more tonally similar to what native drums would have been regular than, or as opposed to like what normal rock drums are. So yeah, I mean, we live in a world of categories. People like categories. People need labels to like put things in and figure out what they like and that sort of thing. So I mean, even this most recent record, people are calling it a protest album. I don't necessarily see it as that. I think that I touch on a lot of issues that are relevant to today, but I'm not very good at writing sort of literal protest songs, just putting an opinion out there. And I think I've tried it before, you know, because there are a lot of songwriters that I really respect and I really like that are good at that. Woody Guthrie, Pete Seeger, they're really good at writing topical, very literal protest songs. My voice doesn't lie there. I can't figure out how it fits in there. So the way that I've kind of taken my sort of stab at it is because there are a lot of issues socially and politically that are important to me, and I want to somehow be a part of that conversation. The way that I've kind of found that I'm trying to write songs is I just kind of try to paint what I see. I try to like bring characters that you need to feel empathy towards, people that are affected by the issues that are important to me, and then maybe someone sees what their lives are and wants to get into that conversation in that way. So it's kind of like a coming in through the back door to kind of get at the issues rather than just write in someone's face right away. So it's just the way that I think I do it best. It's maybe someday I'll get better at writing sort of subjective literal protest songs, but as for now, this is kind of the way that I find that I do it best.
Get out of my head, get out of my dreams. I'm so tired.